welcome.
You're safe with me. I'll be right here, nice and close, so I can speak without alerting the others. Let me tell you about Senua. Her story has already come to an end, but now it begins anew.
What's happening? It's breathing. Dead. It's breathing. It's breathing. He knows she's getting closer. He can feel her coming closer. She's getting
This is a journey deep into darkness. There will be no more stories after this one.
Quiet.
Oh, how rude of me. I never told you of the others. You hear them too, right? They've been around ever since the tragedy. That's not quite true. Some are old. Some are new, but they've changed. I think the darkness changed them, just like it changed her.
Look. Can you see them? Over there.
Why isn't she looking?
Why aren't you looking?
She's in Hellblade.
Look. Up ahead.
Hellblade.
You see it too?
You promised you could.
It is real after all. She's finally arrived in the land of mist and fog. The place the Northmen call Hell.
Turn back.
Go back.
Go back.
It's not safe.
Turn
go
back.
Back. Go back. Go back. Go
it's
back.
It's not safe.
It's there.
They're
here.
Look around and you will see them. The drowned, the sick, the slain. Here they lie, rotting, and the fields and rivers of always lie still here. This is not a place of rest.
You can't do this. Go back, go back.
They're going to do that to you. Can you see them? Can you see them? They're going to do that to you.
What is she thinking? I can tell you. She's afraid. Wouldn't you be? You'd think she would get used to it by now after so many years. But the darkness, it just builds onto itself, growing stronger, towering over her. You might try and ignore it. Turn away. But it's always there, just out of sight, where you're most vulnerable. It's like it knows that just enough light is all you need to see its suffocating power. You might think she's brave to go on this journey on her own, but it isn't bravery that drives her. Bravery only means something to those afraid of death. Senua's fear runs far, far deeper. is she looking at? What is she leaving behind?
I know what she's thinking. I hear her thoughts.
It's not too late to get into the boat and go back. No one will judge her. No one will ever know.
Oh, she heard us. There's no going back.
You can't do it.
Senua pushes away a world that conspired to cause so much suffering. There's nothing to go back to, and worse to look forward to. Why don't you join us? Maybe you too have a part to play in this story.
Focus. Look closer.
Look.
Use your eyes.
Keep looking closer.
She needs to look closer.
Focus.
Knives across which lies the halls of hell, the place they call Helheim. There's no doubt about it. Holds his soul there. My dear beloved. Dillian.
What is she doing? Why is she doing this? Why doesn't she turn back?
She's doing this for him.
He's already dead.
He's dead.
His soul is in hell. His soul is still. She needs to save
the bridge to Helheim.
Where are we?
I forget its name. She forgets to. The old fool said there was a hidden path up to it. Let's see, shall we?
Them.
Don't listen.
I was just hiding. I find I live longer that way. Don't listen.
Mercy.
Never let the bastards catch me again. Never!
Darkness.
Wait. Darkness. Who are you?
It's just a memory.
Truth? Is that you?
Around you now.
For my tales of the Northmen, they call me Druth. A liar.
He's lost.
An old fool.
He's coming.
Druth is my truth.
It's good to see you again. You kept your vow.
To guide you in this life and the next, I will tell you my stories of hell, if I may walk with you.
Tell me your stories again, old friend. I'm listening.
The runes seal the gates to hell. Focus your inner eye, and you too will see what's hidden in plain sight.
Use your eyes. Come on, closer.
I can see one.
Hold it in your mind's eye. Find one like it to open the gate. It's near. Focus. Look towards the gate. And the gate will open.
The gate is open. Go through the gate.
Go through it.
It's dangerous.
Follow it.
What's behind the gate?
Where will it take you?
It's not safe.
It worked.
I spent 6 years enslaved in hell. But I watched the Northmen. Learned their ways.
I know you did.
You listened? When everyone else laughed. My people paid a heavy price. Carry my stories with you. And together we will make the Northmen feel our fury.
Another voice joins us. She was trying to make them go away. Pretend they weren't real. But what good is that? When we are always here. The same with heights. You can stand on the edge, pretend it's going to be okay, but you know that death is near, waiting for you to make that little slip. You can't just wish things away.
Divides the living from the dead. Is that the face of Hela herself? The half-rotten goddess that walks over Helheim. Whatever horrors lie behind that door, she must find him. vision of what's to come. Poor Senua. The darkness does not bargain. It does not reason. It is rot. And now it has taken hold. It will spread towards her head, the seed of the soul, until there is nothing left of her. All of her suffering will have been for nothing. It's just a matter of time. Hardest battles are fought in the mind. That is what Dillian taught her. With every defeat, the dark rot will grow and soon it will take her soul. But for now, at least, she still has control of her mind. And she will fulfill her vow. Whatever the cost.
He's not right.
Listen to me, Senua. The goddess Hela lies behind the gate to Helheim. To open the gate, you must first face the gods that guard it. The god of fire, Surt, and the god of illusion, Valravn, spill their blood to open the gate to Helheim and enter the land of the dead.
To Dillian. To his soul. It won't open.
Valravn, ancestor of the seers and master of ravens. He hunts his prey with his powers of illusion and feasts on their remains. Follow the path to Valravn and defeat him in battle to earn his mark. The gate to Helheim cannot be opened without it.
The Northmen say that Odin and his brothers killed Ymir, and that the world of men was formed from his corpse. They made his bones into stone, and his flesh into earth, and his blood into the salt sea. They set his skull to be the bowl of the sky, with his brains for clouds. Odin and his brothers caught the sparks flying from Muspel and made them into stars. And to protect the new world from the giants, they used Ymir's great curving eyebrows as walls. illusion hides the path to Valravn. Don't trust your eyes.
Find another way to see the truth.
It's a door.
Just close our eyes again and pretend what we saw was never really there. Into the relentless darkness. All that lurks within it. I can see you too.
Illusion comes from ravens, allowing the ravens to break his magic seal.
Show me what you have seen, Truth.
Look how much it's
passing into another world that looks the same but feels different. An imposter world where the forest itself is watching.
Another game.
With the mark of Valravan.
Which ravens? Can't you see which ones? Line up the ravens.
If you hear the song of Valravan, follow it, and it will lead you to him. But be aware of his illusions. You can't always trust your eyes.
And we think of a shadow in the woods. A creature in the night. If only it were that simple. The worst kind comes without warning.
She can't go in there.
A deep and primal signal from within.
Barrett, he's there.
A reminder that just because you cannot see the threat, mean that it's not already here.
Go round. Find your own path.
There's a different way.
Northmen say you must sacrifice in order to receive. They tell how the runes were revealed to Odin only in sacrifice. He hung himself from the world tree, and he stabbed himself with a spear, and he dedicated the sacrifice to himself. For 9 nights he hung on the tree without food or drink, and at last he saw the runes below him. He gave a cry and gathered them in his mind and learnt them. Then he fell from the tree.
Do you know what it's like to leave everything behind? A home, loved ones, to head deep into the wilds, perhaps never to return. Senua does. Because when darkness speaks, it changes everything. Turning home into a foreign land and loved ones into strangers. Exile makes sense when you realize that you were never really home in the first place.
The Northmen say that Odin is always in search of knowledge and wisdom and magic. There was a very wise being named Mimir who guarded the waters of wisdom which flow from the roots of the world tree. Odin wished to drink from this spring, but he had to pay a price. So he gouged out his own eye as offering to Mimir. He drank from the well and traded one way of seeing for another.
Reminds her of somewhere.
The forest.
Where? Which forest? That forest in my mind.
The wilds.
She left the wild.
She went to the wilds a long time.
Why did she go to the wild?
She wanted to fight her own darkness. She thought she could beat her own darkness.
Did she beat the darkness?
No. It nearly killed her, but she tried.
Druth helped her.
If it wasn't for Druth, she'd be dead.
She can't beat her own darkness. She wanted to marry Dillian. She came to beat her own darkness and marry Dillian. But it didn't work.
She thought her curse would affect him.
She thought her curse would spread to him. She thought she'd bring the darkness to him too. She nearly died.
She thought the curse made her tainted.
Druth helped her.
The ravens.
The ravens.
They've gone.
They've gone.
No.
Half of them have gone.
They've gone.
But where?
The ravens.
He's not helping.
It's true.
Quiet. Quiet.
Out in the wilds. In cold winter woods.
Where?
She no longer felt fit for this world. She almost gave in to the darkness. She remembered Dillian's words. She remembered her promise. She resolved to fight on and kill that which had become a part of her.
Where have they gone?
Gone.
She did it. What does it mean? She...
Looking back, I consumed her whole. There is no such thing as victory when it comes to the darkness had her in its claws. It's like it doesn't want to kill her. Yet, I will gnaw at her, biding its time. Only when she is at her weakest will it strike. She find Dillian before her time comes.
Overcome Valravn's final illusion to face him in his keeping. I know you can do it, Senua. You have the sight.
We both see the darkness. We can fight it together.
Speak to me, Drew. Tell me a story.
Senua, listen. I will tell you the tale of a man called Findon. The Northmen captured Findon's sister, and his father sent him to pay for her release. But they took his gold, put him in chains, and held him for a day and a night without food or water. Then they released him. I don't know why. Upon his return, his father's enemies in Erin set fire to his home. His father burnt to death, and his brother was killed. But he escaped with sorrow in his heart. His father's enemies offered redress for his loss and invited him to a feast. It was at a hall near the sea. And when there, they betrayed him to the Northmen, who enslaved him and took him to hell. 6 years later, his slave masters landed on the shores of Orkney, burning all before them. And into that fire, Findon made his escape. What was Findon burnt away that day? But from the flames, a new man stepped forward, and Druth was born. Druth. Though Findon never set eyes on his dear sister again, I, Inua.
But you could have seen my home before these dark times.
Gate is open!
It's open!
He did it! It's darkness. I know it from the wilds. It's coming back for me. I remember. It didn't end well in the wilds. It never does. You think you can overcome the darkness, make sense of it, and once relief settles in,
strikes out of nowhere, throwing you helplessly back into the maelstrom. Drowning the mind in fear, deeper, deeper, dragging you down so far into the void that maybe this time there is no coming back.
But there, in the darkness,
Senua.
She remembered what he told her.
Hear me. Reach out to me. Senua, take my iron mirror. Look into it. For it is a window into the unlocked. Within, you will see the face of the darkness that you fear. And if you focus, like I have taught you to, you will also see that as much as the darkness has you trapped within its veil, it too is trapped within yours. Focus! Focus! Focus!
I see you now. You led me to the wilds. You trapped me there.
Behind you.
never beat you in the wilds, did I? It was an illusion. But not this time!
The mark of Valravn. One of the keys to the gate to Helheim. Hold it in your mind's eye.
With every battle, the darkness grows stronger. Every victory, bringing her closer to defeat. Unfair, isn't it? In those dark winter nights in the wilds, there were times when she considered letting go. If it weren't for Druth, a chance encounter in the wilds, she would not have heard his stories of the Northmen. And she would not have this chance to find Dillian's soul.
I'm coming.
Senua, you have the sight, just like I do. Once you can see into the underworld and all the souls within it will see you. Don't be afraid when they speak to you. I will always be here to guide you.
Did you see her? That was her mother, Galina. She was a priestess, a healer. She taught Senua to see the weave that binds the world together. And it was beautiful. It was a time before the darkness. But when it did come, it first came for her mother. Senua still sees her face from time to time, hidden in the world. Like she's still watching over. She misses her so much.
another challenge. There's another challenge.
She hasn't challenged Sert.
Sert, the fire giant, has answered. He comes from a land older than mankind. And the Northmen call upon his flaming sword to raise their enemies to the ground. Find him, Senua, and spill his blood.